Hello everyone, I am Professor Isaac Khan and today is 9th topic and that topic is chemical bonding. Chemical bonding, when we are saying it is the nature of chemical bonding, there are different type of bonding. One is called ionic bonding, that is electrovalent bonding. Second one is covalent bonding. Third one is coordinate bonding. Fourth one is hydrogen bonding, and of course sigma and pi bonding. But before going to electronic bonding, let me come and explain that the term bonding, chemical bonding concept came and it was suggested by Pauling. And according to Pauling's suggestion, that the bonding force between atoms of the same or different elements leading to the formation of a stable molecule is called chemical bonding. So actually, according to him, that the chemical bonding is the electrostatic forces, those forces are acting and that gives the stable molecule, that is called bonding. So the first one is ionic or electrovalent bonding. But before going to that chemical bonding, I am going to explain more about the arrangement of electron in the atom. So for that arrangement, you know, three terms are widely used. First is called, that is CONFUGRATION configuration. The second term is widely used, that is configuration, and third one is called conformation. So these three terms are widely used. First is configuration, there is U. Second one is configuration, and third one is conformation. Configuration of atom means it is the arrangement of electron in shell and subshell. That is called configuration. And configuration, where I is there. Configuration means the arrangement of atoms within the molecule. That is called configuration. And conformation is having the space concept. Means the different arrangement of the molecules in the space. For example, if I take this hexane, cyclohexane. So cyclohexane conformation means it can be in chair form. It can be in boat form, it can be half twisted, it can be full twisted. So that is the difference in these three terms, configuration, conformation and configuration. Now come to that point. Yeah, your three terms are clear. Now let me show you how the electrons are arranged in shell and subshell. You see the shells are K, L, M and N, means the capacity of keeping the electron in these shells are 2, 8, 18 and 32. And these shells are having subshells, and those subshells are S, P, D and F. And the capacity of keeping the electrons in these subshells, are 2, 6, 10 and 14. So these are the arrangement of electrons. For example, first shell will be like, if it is nucleus, the first one will be having the circular one, means 2 electron. Then it will start like this. First one will be having 2 electrons. Second one will be having 8 electrons, and like that it will proceed. So how the electrons are arranged in shells? Now, when we are talking of electrons, definitely we should have very clear picture of energy level. That is called energy level. Energy level means one condition where, for example, if it is, let us say it is K shell, it is L shell, It is M cell and it is N cell. And these cells, K, L, M, N, and these are having electrons. So one electron which is in K cell is very close to nucleus, while the electron which is in N is far away from the nucleus. So there are two conditions in atom for electron. One condition where the electron is very close to nucleus. The second condition where electron is far away from the nucleus. For example, one electron is, let us see, is here, and one electron is here. So A condition and B condition. For example, there are two atoms, A and B. In A, one electron is very close to nucleus. In B, the electron is far away from the nucleus. My question here is, which electron will contain more energy? That is, the one which is very close to nucleus or the one which is far away from the nucleus. So for your confirmation, the one which is very close to nucleus, you should not have any confusion, that will be having low energy, low intensity of E charges, low energy. And the one which is far away, so here now it is very clear now, and the concept of energy level, that high energy, low energy, it comes in this way, that for example, if there is heater which is plugged and lot of heat is radiated, the one who is sitting in front of heater and the other one is sitting far away from the heater, who is going to be affected more? The one who is sitting just in front, because of its heat. So same thing, the electron which is very close to positive charge, it is going, there is lot of cancellation of intensity of negative charge here, and the one which is far away from the influence of positive charge, is visibility, its intensity of a negative charge is not going to be much affected. That's why this electron in far away position means, if it is nucleus and if it is K, L, M and N. So in the electron which is in N shell and orbital, that will contain high amount of energy, and the one which is in K will contain low amount of energy. That is the concept of high energy. Then again, the how electrons are placed, for example, one is, means it is having two electrons. S is having two electrons. How these two electrons are placed in subshell? That is very important to understand from energy point of view. One condition is like this, where two spins are on the same side, the arrow is on the same side, and the one condition where the two electrons are, the spin is in opposite direction. Here it is in opposite direction, and here two electrons are on the same direction. And the one which is in the same direction is called singlet arrangement, is called singlet arrangement of electron. And the one which, where the two electrons are in opposite spin, is called triplet triplet arrangement. So these two possibilities of arrangement of electrons are there in their subshell. The question is, which one is more stable? The triplet state, where these two electrons are in opposite spin, or the one which is in spins, they are in the same direction, and it is called unpaired. This condition is called unpaired of electron. And this is called paired. So one is paired, one is unpaired. So whether singlet state of arrangement of electron in subshell is more stable, or the triplet state of arrangement of electron in subshell is more stable. The question is, again, on the basis of energy, which subshell will contain more energy? So for your kind information, this singlet state of arrangement of subshell contains more energy. This subshell contains more energy as compared to tubular. So the any system which contains more energy means it is towards instability. So the singlet state of arrangement of electron in the atom, in the subshell, will be unstable. And the tubular form of arrangement of electrons in the atom, in subshell, will be more stable. So that's why the preferred one, in most of the cases, 90% cases, except in some circumstances, otherwise most of the arrangement in atom, the electrons are in triplet state. Now the question comes, why it is having more energy and why it is having less energy? It is just like in the same way, if I am keeping these two, I think you can see these two barrow. If suppose it is, there are two heads, now I want to make it is in singlet state, I want to make it triplet, opposite spin. How it is possible? Is it if I am going to read something, some spiritual, some supernatural power? No. Unless I bring my one hand and apply the biological energy and flip it into opposite direction, only then it is triplet state. So here, to flip one of the electron, this electron, the energy is used from inside and it is changed into, flip into opposite direction. That's why what energy is used is less here and it is more here. Because of that reason, the triplet state of arrangement is more stable as compared to singlet. Thank you very much.